This is State Senator Rob Ortt. Thanks for joining me for a review of the 2015 legislative session. In Albany this week, we finished up a lengthy and unpredictable session with a broad overall agreement on many legislative issues. With such a diverse state, regionally and politically, it was challenging to get all parties to reach an agreement. But I'm encouraged that we were able to come to an agreement with the governor and the assembly while still fighting for Western New York. There's good news on issues very important to Western New Yorkers, such as tax relief, education, and job creation. Now, despite efforts to dramatically scale back the property tax cap, not only were we able to keep it intact, but we extended it for another 4 years. Just this year, the property tax cap will save New York taxpayers over $1 billion. Now, I believe the state should lead by example. That's why I fought to keep state spending under the same 2% growth that applies to our local governments and school districts under the property tax cap. This fiscal restraint will save state taxpayers over $1.5 billion this year alone. Now, these savings will result in larger property tax relief checks and record funding for STAR and Enhanced STAR. Together, these measures deliver major tax relief and provide stability to hardworking families, small businesses, and seniors who for so many years have been burdened by runaway government spending. We also helped secure a key victory for Western New York children, parents, and teachers through record investments in our schools, libraries, and museums. We delivered an additional $25 million in state education aid to schools in my district. And we also eliminated nearly all of the anti-upstate gap elimination adjustment, or GEA, which will save taxpayers in my district $18 million. Not only did we push back on some of the governor's extreme education policies, but we were able to introduce our own measures to comprehensively review Common Core, release tests to help students and teachers, and ensure that tests are age appropriate. Job creation and economic development is another very critical matter for Western New York and has been my top priority. We've taken important steps to strengthen agriculture, redevelop brownfields, reduce energy rates, fund infrastructure, and expand green technology. These are important first steps to rebuilding the Western New York economy. In other areas, we increased critical services to veterans returning from combat, children without adequate health care, women subjected to rape and domestic violence, victims of mental illness, and individuals and families affected by disabilities. Stricter measures against drug dealers and sex offenders will help keep our families and communities safe. For example, years after the Amanda Lynn Winkowski tragedy, years after intense negotiations, I'm pleased to report that Amanda Lynn's law passed both the Senate and the Assembly. But we still have a lot of work to do on these and other issues. For example, the governor and the assembly walked away from our common sense reforms to the unconstitutional SAFE Act. But I know through hard work and with your help, we can continue to make progress for Western New York and for our entire state. Thanks for joining me to discuss this legislative session. It's been a privilege to serve you, and I look forward to seeing you around the district. I'm Rob Ortt. Good luck, and God bless.